Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy! Welcome back to more Splatoon! Last time, we recovered yet another scroll lost to the Octarians and rebuilt from it the Aerospray! With a fan of shots that wide, it was hardly a narrow spray! This time, we find ourselves back in Ingopolis Plaza, where we're gonna be doing something kind of interesting to say the least, yes! This is going to be a video based entirely on aspects of multiplayer. I kind of figured that any time that we have a guest to show off something like that, we wouldn't have story progress in it just to kind of separate the two videos. And so if you're not really into watching just multiplayer stuff, you don't really have to have it intermixed with the story. So today we are going to be taking a look at the Battle Dojo in Ingopolis Plaza, a feature that you can only play with another person. So as this is a local multiplayer feature, I have brought with me with a guest. Introduce yourself.
Hello, I am the local multiplayer bot. Beep boop, beep boop, beep boop.
Well, I mean at this point on this channel, but...
Hey, you shut up. You shut up. Are we going to start fighting?
Well, I mean, we are technically fighting here today.
Okay, bring it on then. Bring it, bring it. Come on, come on, bring it, bring it. Bring it, boy.
Oh, boy.
Are we going? Are we doing the thing?
If your name is Local Multiplayer Bot, then sure, you've introduced yourself just fine.
Oh, right, I didn't actually say it.
No.
Okay, hey guys, I am a Sayanella. I'm going to splat him really hard. Splat, splat. I forgot to say my name.
Now, to a lot of people, myself included, motion controls in Splatoon are very important. And... there's not really any control option other than the gamepad that would give you all the necessary buttons plus the motion controls, but don't worry. Nintendo has thought of an official solution for you should you want to do local multiplayer with only one gamepad. Dun dun dun!
Official solution. Guess what monstrosity I'm using?
You know,
thanks,
I offered to cut the ends of the zip ties off, but...
it's the principle of the matter!
You just want to use a worse controller so you can complain more about it.
No, maybe, no.
Now, you sound like a race car. Anyway, so you press the LZR to confirm. And when selecting your controls, you have to hold down on the D-pad, press B, then ZL and ZR. And that will allow you to go in with motion controls.
I
can
hope.
You check the settings? No.
No?
What
the frick?
Maybe it's down on the D-pad and be on the Wii mode and not on, like, Pro Controller?
We have been trying to get this working for the past 20 minutes. I would like to add that right now.
Let's try again.
20 minutes! Just to get this stupid controller to work!
We finally got it working, and do you care to list off the laundry list of things you have to do in order to make it do it?
You have to press down and B on...
hold down and B.
Okay, hold down and B on the Wii U Pro Controller, and then press ZLZR to enter this screen, and on this screen, you have to press 2 on the Wii U Pro...
not on the Wiimote.
The Wiimote, sorry.
After strapping your two controllers together.
After making it into the hodgepodge of monstrosity that it is.
I heard it works real great.
Yeah, you were saying like several times before we got started, don't worry, it works great.
I think it would be good if you didn't have to input the dang Contra code to be able to access it. Okay, anyway, so on the weapon select, things are a bit more limited in the Battle Dojo. It's one-on-one, so they're going to limit your capabilities a little bit to make it a bit more balanced. You may pick from... splatter shot, splat roller, splat charger, blaster, rapid blaster, which we haven't gone over yet, classic squiffer, aerospray MG, and jet squelcher. 7 out of 8 ain't bad.
Or you can be everything!
I'm just too slow for you. You didn't like the speed at which I was explaining things. So, okay, you're going... of course you're going splatter shots.
Well, I mean... I really like Splattershot.
You're Tentatrash?
I'm very much Tentatrash, but I feel bad if you're gonna play something that you're not, like, familiar with, so it depends on what you pick.
Okay. You might notice that none of these kits have their specials, because some of them would be, shall we say...
broken.
Yeah. Eloquently put, if you're doing one-on-one. So... This jet squelcher is tempting. I love the splash wall. It's great, and that range would be awesome, though, but I'd have to four hit you because there's no equipment in this mode either other than just what it sticks you with by default. That blaster's looking nice. That disruptor. I love disruptor so much. Then again, you outrange me, and it's a tough call because I know you're good.
I mean, if you're going to use something that you're not familiar with, then I'll hold off on the Tentatec.
No, go ahead and pick it. It's not even the Tentatec. It's the regular splatter shot.
I mean, it's the same gun.
Just pick it.
Okay, fine. Fine.
Let's, You know what? I was actually a little disappointed I didn't get to show off the Jet Squelcher, the vanilla one, though, because it is good on certain maps and certain modes. So you know what? I'm going to go for it.
Okay.
Now, in local multiplayer, you have a fifth battle mode over the four that we have seen already. So technically, Tower Control was not the last of the new modes that there were to go over. Balloon Battle. Battle Dojo hosts one-on-one battles with specialized rules. Your objective is to pop more balloons than your opponent. Be the first to pop 30 balloons or pop more balloons than your opponent to win. But you'll lose balloon points for getting splatted, though, so watch your back. Balloons are worth double in the last minute. Do I smell a comeback?
What do comebacks smell like? Sweaty?
I was gonna say like old shoes, and I guess that's kind of the same thing. But, or is that the sweet smell of the leader sealing the deal?
Ew.
Also, a limited selection of weapon sets are available in Battle Dojo, and your loadout will consist of just a main weapon and a sub-weapon. But you can still use special weapons by finding them in cans during play,
so
similar
like
to Octo Valley. Sorry?
No, I just said, so like Octo Valley.
Yeah, we're just so in sync. Picking up a canned special gives a random ability. Exciting, right? Splattering ink on the ground won't earn you points in Battle Dojo, but having a lot of ink to swim around in and hide is definitely an advantage.
Yo!
And don't forget to use skills you pick up in the Battle Dojo in other modes. So this is a sparring mode. It will help you sharpen your fighting abilities. If maybe you have a little brother that wants to get better at the game, this will show them like how to fight, but it is a little frustrating, I guess. But yeah, if you want to get better at one-on-one fighting, and
if you have half an hour to kill to figure out how to actually activate the dang controller, then
it's great. All right, so for the maps, we have a few to choose from. These are the first five maps that were available in Splatoon by default. Had a bit of a change of heart on the weapons. We're just gonna go with the regular splatter shot. I tried out the Jet Squelcher, and it was incredibly frustrating, to say the least.
It was not a good matchup.
No. So we're going to be going into Urchin Underpass for very good reason.
Nostalgia factor!
I briefly mentioned that there was still a way that you could see what Urchin Underpass was like back in the early days of Splatoon, and here it is, yeah! So I got up an ink strike right there, got a can special. I think it just kind of homes in automatically on its target. Maybe that's what they'll do in Splatoon 2. And I see you got the same thing. Okay. Balloons are spawning in 5 seconds, so you just look at that timer, you do that, and
oh, I actually didn't even notice the timer.
Good. Jeez. Aggressive enough? I know you're very good.
Aggressive is my playstyle.
I know, much to my bane.
A little bit too aggressive sometimes.
Go. Got another balloon over there. Disruptor! Okay, I can live with that. So you're gonna have a slow movement speed. Various specials and subs that would be overpowered are used as power-ups in this, so you have like an item roulette like Mario Kart. I don't know if it's actually the case though, but I've always noticed that generally when somebody's in the lead, they get worse stuff. So maybe it does rubber band like that. You got an ink Zuko, so you basically have Tentatec.
Hello, Tentatec!
Tentatec.
When does this thing run out?
It's actually very long. Ah, no, as soon as I get the lead, of course. I respawn there. Can't special right by my spawn. Let's see what we get. Oh, now I have an ink Zuka. Oh, whoa. Of course.
Canceled.
Okay. Can special over here, please. Thank you. Super jump. We switched places. I think that might have actually helped you.
I think it did. Yes. Yeah, it definitely did.
Wow, what complete.
Oh!
You got every balloon.
Oh no!
Okay, got you. At least I cost you something. Point sensor, so I know where you are hiding, but you're too fast for me! And you got a disruptor?
Nice, good job.
This is lasting so long, holy crap. get up there. Hurry! Hurry! I see her coming! No!
Nope, not quite.
You have...
It seems to last a lot longer.
Yeah,
than
the
in
specials
the
and subs last forever. Ink Strike. If only that could last forever.
I threw a sprinkler on the thing.
Oh, good usage of the burst bomb right there. But not good enough. Is that you?
Oh, I thought I was gonna get you.
Let's play an effective range. Oh, you respond very quickly. Yeah, I found your sprinkler just now. That's kind of funny. Low score in game, by the way.
Yeah, no kidding, right?
2-3.
Oh, there's a balloon.
Yeah, it's over by where that... It looks like it says 7 versus 7, and it always confuses me. Because I'm like, isn't it 1 versus 1? But, yeah.
Hi!
Hi!
How's it going over there?
We killed each other, too. God, you lose half of your points when you die. That's really hard.
Is it 5, or is it just...
No, like, I lost 1 when I died, you lost 5. I had 2, you had 10.
Oh... I spit out another sprinkler.
Is that you? Now, I'm taking the lead. If you kill me, I still have it, too. I saw you got a special over there. A bubbler. Well, I'm getting the hell out of Dodge. I don't know about you.
Where are you?
Maybe you'll find out when I disrupt you. Good time for that disruptor to come out.
I actually didn't get affected by it.
What?
Yeah.
Ow.
I don't know.
I know what I got. I know how to read, I hope. Maybe I read, I don't know, a sprinkler. I was joking about getting a sprinkler and then I actually got it and I stuck it to like a pointless wall that was next to nothing. Okay, balloons are spawning in 3, 2. Got another sprinkler. I think the game does read that I have a big lead over you, so it's not giving me good stuff. No, okay, so -5 I think is the most it can take away from you, so it's not outright -0.5. Balloon spawning in 20 more seconds. Bubbler. Wait, full power up, okay. Full power up is a weird power up. I think it's basically like opening Gambit in Versus. Wait a minute. Overtime, we have a tie score.
Hi.
Because of course you did. I didn't think they were gonna spawn in time. Alright, we'll do one more. We'll do one more.
This is a terrible idea.
You've met with a terrible fate, haven't you?
I don't know, it might work.
We're gonna do another match. If you win, we'll just call it there. If I win, maybe we'll do a tiebreaker or something like that. These are pretty long games, actually. I think they have like a 5-minute time limit. So they're basically a ranked match. Sam, I'm a big fan of being able to spread ink around. I think that is going to give me a lot of help in this right here. So you're playing a Squiffer. I didn't think you were even there yet.
Yep.
You were saying that this is a terrible idea.
I said it might work.
You did? I didn't hear that part.
Yeah, I said
I just
it
heard
might
this
work.
Is a terrible idea.
I said that going into it because I was a little bit nervous.
Screw you so much! Trying to be tactical. Yes!
Nice.
Oh, it's so satisfying beating a good Squiffer. Really is.
Good Squiffer?
Well, relatively compared to myself.
Okay, fair enough. I can't see!
You? Ink Strike. Whoopee. Super-
Hi!
Hi! We high-fived in midair. That was cute. Ah, no! And you have free reign of the bombs, of course you do. Or bombs balloons. Hi.
Ah, shoot.
Okay, I've taken the lead. Question is if I can maintain it.
Oh, that was a close.
Wow,
that
was cool. That was very cool. Zuka, I think. Ha! Who is the sniper now?
Well, a new Zuka isn't really.
You know what I meant. Having to be so tactical when playing against you with this.
Oh, you reach me, you reach me.
Ah!
Gotcha. Now I shall claim my prize of however many points this is worth. I see you, don't think I don't. Oh, no!
Hello.
That's so harsh how many points it takes. Okay. You?
Ooh, nice one.
Thank
I gotta say that I am usually used to having ink resist up, like, all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So not having it, I keep running into your ink and getting stuck.
Yeah, not having gear abilities does feel a little bit weird if you're not used to this mode. It's a great way to get used to fighting in, like, any situation because of that, though, but it is a little bit awkward. That was quite a scrap, wow.
I was hoping.
Balloons are spawned in.
A sprinkler!
Yeah, saw that. No! I still got the lead, though. I still got the lead. Gotta just maintain it for one more minute. Got you. And in that. Bubbler. I found your sprinkler. I'm taking very good care of it. I'm turning it into an orange sprinkler, but it just simply couldn't handle the change and it died. Oh, wow. With the seeker explosion. Alright, now I just gotta camp for the rest of the time limit and I'll be good. I'll be frank.
I'm having a hard time getting the full charge off.
Ooh.
Oh! Hello!
Oh, no! Oh, that respawn, you got lucky. That respawn just put you right on top of me. This is not the time for sprinklers game!
You're in the lead!
Yeah, but no! I can't die again, I can't die again, I can't die again. Oh my gosh, you're gonna take it, aren't you?
I don't know, but I'm running away!
I couldn't find you. Where were you?
I was running for the hills!
No surprise that I lost you. By 1 point both times.
Oh boy, those are close games.
Yeah. Alright, well, I guess with that done, now we're going to be going into versus. Things are a little bit different here, so you're going to be going into versus with me.
Yay!
I can't be good at every weapon. I have fully admitted when I am terrible with a weapon, and today's weapon of the day is one that I am absolutely terrible with, so I brought what could be, platonically described as a friend with me.
What?
Oh, wait, that's not what platonic means.
No.
Oh.
I mean...
Platonic is friend... Lee.
Nice.
Good
job, Emil.
Peripherally described as a friend. It's a P word, okay? Anyway, do you care to introduce the weapon of the day?
With the power of friendship, I am going to introduce the L3 Nozzle-nose.
Nozzle-nose.
Nozzle nose. I said it right.
This one goes out to all my fellow big noses out there. The L3 nozzle nose. Our first nozzle nose, no less. That's fun to say. I like saying the word nozzle nose. While classified as shooter, I like to think of this more as its own weapon class, as it's completely different from everything else we have seen so far. It's a semi-automatic shooter, firing three shots with every press of ZR, and it has no continuous fire. This might turn you off to it entirely, and it's definitely a playstyle that's not for everyone. But the range is a solid 60, placing it above most common shooters. It only loses out to the .96 Gal, Splattershot Pro, and the Squelchers. Not a bad resume whatsoever. Aiming from a great distance and having the sharp judgment to wait for the exact right moment to shoot is far more necessary here than it is for other styles. Again, it's not for everyone. The rate of fire between three shots is a decent 65, and the damage from a direct hit is 29. With that rate of fire, usually at least two of the three bullets will connect if one of them hits. Regardless, it takes four bullets and by extension two trigger pulls to splat somebody at full health. It's good at picking off enemies that have already taken damage and at pressuring choke points in the map, since one good trigger pull from a distance will send the enemy running. They wouldn't want to get hit by another one of those. It might seem like a semi-automatic weapon in Splatoon would be incredibly slow and clumsy, but with good rhythm, it can almost seem as though you're playing an automatic weapon from your opponent's point of view and catch them off guard. Mobility, however, is a weak point. The three shots fired will hit the ground in small disconnected splatters, much too spotty to swim through. Though some patches have given it higher movement stats, it's still not very good compared to other light shooters when compared directly. To make up for its bad mobility, its default strafing speed while firing is very solid. A common misconception about Nozzle Nose is that it's terrible at breaking the Rainmaker shield. And this was true when it first came out, but the bullets now have high Rainmaker shield damage and making it actually workable. I think you can see now why I would consider this to be its own separate weapon class. For everything that a shooter does, it has some great exception or gimmick or technicality that sets it apart from the others, or it just has some unique attribute in place of what a shooter normally does in that situation. Its sub-weapon is Disruptor. This is the entire backbone to playing the L3 Nozzle Nose well. It means that you'll have a much easier time aiming and shooting at long range as the shots travel. You'll be landing two, if not all three, bullets with a trigger pull. And on top of that, it just makes it a lot more viable at fighting and makes it so that it has something it can do when enemies are starting to get too close. Plus, with the lack of continuous fire, you'll be hard-pressed to not have enough ink to use this whenever you need it. And its special is Killer Whale. Due to the turf coverage not being the greatest out there, it's very nice that this is the cheapest special in the game. Most chargers outrange the L3 Nozzle Nose, and this helps with that problem. We've been over all this before, but it kills in narrow hallways and flushes out the enemy otherwise. It can be used to set up for a disruptor throw if their movement is predictable in where you have used it. Overall, between the weapon's capabilities, sub, and special, this is a weapon extremely focused on killing other players above anything else. Using a disruptor to stop someone from swimming out of the way of the killer whale is a mean tactic and oh so satisfying. For equipment, I'm going to recommend Run Speed Up and Ink Resist Up the strongest. This weapon does a lot more running on foot than other shooters, and it can't make paths to quickly swim through, so strafing speed is your greatest strength. The alternate kit is L3 Nozzle Nose D, same stats, but with medium special depletion, and of course, a new sub and a new special. Getting to those, it has Burst Bomb. So good for this weapon. Useful at trapping an enemy into a corner or finishing off approaching opponents who were hit by two or three bullets, but are proving hard to aim at, since the Burst Bomb has a much larger hitbox than your bullets do. Or heck, even as softening up an opponent and giving them a movement penalty by surrounding them with your ink so that you can take a shot with perfect timing. It does 60 base damage with a direct hit, and two can be thrown on a full tank. And that's not even mentioning the fact that this makes it so much more mobile when swimming around. And its special is the Kraken. On this set, it's a panic button and not a whole lot else. Because the Nozzle Nose needs to play its range well and the special leaves it weak to snipers, compared to the Killer Whale on the first set and how expensive it is to build up the Kraken, it might not be able to fall back on this terribly often. I still believe the L3 Nozzle Nose D to be the best Nozzle Nose out there, and it's definitely what I see played the most. But the special might not complement it as well as other specials could have. It might be a Kraken weapon, though not in the most traditional of senses. I'd highly recommend having Ink Saver sub on it, as you would want to fire more bullets after throwing double burst bombs. Possibly even throwing a third burst bomb if you want to pack a lot of it. Plus, damage up was good on the L3 Nozzle Nose. It's great on the L3 Nozzle Nose D. Even the slightest little clip from a burst bomb will set you up to be able to kill in one trigger press. So what maps are you going to kick my ass with the L3 nozzle nose today? Let's see. You hold on to your tentacles now. You'll get to do it in just a moment. Our regular battle stages for the day are Museum Dolphoncino. It takes all day to really appreciate the art here. No need for that. Just glance as you run by. Piranha Pit. This is a great stage to go crazy with the slosher. Sure. I guess if you're into that sort of thing, that's totally the face you want to wake up next to. Yeah. And the ranked battle stages, I don't think we're going to be going into, but let's see. We got Urchin Underpass. How fitting. And I swear if the second one is Walleye Warehouse. Ah, dang it. I was hoping. Anchovy Games. I feel so guilty running on top of people's desks. Not guilty enough to stop doing it, though. I was hoping you'd chime in with the Stay Fresh, but oh well.
Oh, Stay Fresh! Is that good?
I don't think I'm going to be playing the L3 Nozzle Nose. I think I'm just going to be leaving that to you because you're our guest and you're the person that I brought in to play that weapon. And I kind of thought we should have somebody who at least kind of knows what they're doing playing it, aka not me.
Kind of.
So I'm going to be picking another weapon, an alternate kit of something we've seen in the past that I was sad that I couldn't get to play. Aerospray PG!
Nice.
Gee, that worked out nicely.
I wonder why you played that earlier.
I'm going to stick with the opening gambit on the headgear. So much for that being the only time we'd ever get to show it. Decided to not go with stealth jump any longer and instead go with ink resist up on my shoes and a little bit more swim speed up. Just going to go all in on the movement speed, try to get as much turf covered at the beginning of the map as possible. I kind of sort of wanted to do aerospray RG, but A, I am trash with ink mines. I'm going to have to play them eventually, though, but
okay. Not
against you.
We might play with each other, though.
Maybe, if I'm lucky. And then the other thing is that the Ink Strike. It's Piranha Pit and Museum Dolphoncino. It's the worst map in the game for Ink Strikes with the best map in the game for Ink Strikes in the same map rotation, so...
That makes it a little bit...
It was a little hard to choose.
Yeah.
But I think I'm going to go with the PG... I'm going to show you that there's no hard feelings about not only what I said about you last time in being an outclassed weapon, but also no hard feelings in my parents not letting me watch you until I was 8 years old. Yes, that's a thing my parents really did.
For a second, I thought you were actually, like, talking directly to me because you were looking at me when you said that, and I was like, what?
Oh. Anyway, how about you tell us what your equipment spread's looking like?
Okay, well, I'm using the L3 Nozzle Nose D because I find this to be a lot better than the vanilla. The vanilla's fun. But it's just burst bomb. It's such a perfect match.
What's the D stand for? Donuts?
No.
Okay. It actually stands for Dolphin, if you're curious.
Oh, does it?
Yes. Dolphin really? Is a fashion brand in Splatoon, and they made the L3 Nozzle Nose D.
Oh!
That's what the sticker shows on it.
Oh, that's actually really cool. Oh, you're right!
Yeah.
I never knew that!
Kind of a fun bit of trivia.
Oh, shoot! You just taught me something new. I actually didn't know about that. I'm a little bit jazzed now. Anyway, so for my headgear and a little bit of my shoe equipment, I have a little bit of damage up. This gets me up to 98.9 for base damage with no defense
98.9?
up. 98.9? Yeah, 98.9 for 3 shots. 3 bullets.
You mean 99.9? Because, like, if you're doing 33.333...
I'm not doing 33.333333333.
Sorry.
I'm undercutting it a little bit because I wanted another piece of equipment.
Okay, I understand. That's what I was trying to clarify because you can get up to 99 with.
Yeah, you technically can, but okay. I'm not in this set. I'm just mentioning that one main and 2 subs of damage up gets me up to 98.9.
Okay, gotcha.
Anyway, the Ink Saver main and the Ink Recovery up are pretty much just because they were on these pieces of equipment, and they're not terrible to have on the L3 Nozzle Nose D, but it's not the most ink-hungry weapon out there. That one little only sub of
Special Duration up?
Thank you. You said it without even...
I couldn't even see your screen from here, I guess.
Thanks, Emil. Thank you very much. Is just there because, and my clothes. This is my baby. This is my baby of babies, and I love this thing so much. It is run speed up and triple swim speed up, because why not?
Oh, that is excellent.
I love this thing. This is like my bread and butter for all of my equipment.
3 subslots of an ability is very, very close to having 1 main slot. It's not quite the same. It's like less than 1% difference, so it might as well be, but
Just practically
for,
is.
For movement speed, that's awesome. It's better than the shirt I'm using, I'll even concede, as much as I love this shirt. And I guess I'm the construction center chef once again?
Oh, I'm the sailor. The sailor...
Mouth?
Sailor mouth?
No, whatever. Just give it a title.
The sailor hoser downer.
I feel like there's an innuendo in there somewhere.
Okay, never mind. What? I'm just the jeans person with the sailor hat.
Let's just go into our regular battle. So, whenever your friends are online, you can join them if they're on your friend list. And every single time, I get to see Proton John's smug little face staring at me to be like, "Hi, I haven't played this game in over a year. But you know what? If I did, I would totally beat you at it."
Hey.
What?
He did play under a year ago. He played in my stream. What's that face?
Anyway, I'm just gonna open up a regular battle, you'll join in my lobby, and we'll get straight to it.
Yep. Come on.
Second game.
Yeah!
Second game, yeah! There we go! It is a little bit tough to get in on the first game, so generally your friend will be playing at least one game before they join in, though. So, long play sessions, they lend themselves well to having your friends join in unexpectedly. It's nice.
Yep.
Our team does not have you on it, you're on the enemy team. So, I think I'm just going to hand things over to you, and you can just kind of explain what you're doing at the start of the match.
Okay, start of the match, I tend to kind of focus on getting the Kraken up, because, you know, Kraken is a great panic button for this weapon. But, I tend to be super aggressive. I kind of bought my head there. So...
I thought you said bought your head, and I'm just like, how much did it cost?
Too expensive for your blood.
You were saying...
Shut up!
Your blood is the blood that was affordable today!
Shut up!
It sounds like something Fawful would say.
I had no ink left! So, apparently I suck. I suck at getting things rolling. But...
Got any more hot tips for us?
Aim well.
Aim well, don't suck, move a lot.
Pretty much.
Cover the ground. Oh no!
Oh, I saw that!
I had my... Oh!
Oh, I missed the ledge.
I was conserving my Kraken there because I'm like, I haven't needed it yet, and I've already gotten a kill, and I've covered lots of ground, I've done lots of good stuff, and I was worried that guy wasn't moving for a second, but no, he is.
Whoop! There we go, I got someone.
Saw you. Oh, your sniper is actually really good, wow.
Yeah, I keep seeing him shooting people.
Jeez. His name is Yak. It's like Isaac, but without the S, and it's a yak.
Whoop! Yeah, Kraken!
Oh man, they are, oh boy. Oh boy, is just my catch. Frick! They super jump. Wow! They are very adept at what they do. I need to be super jumping.
Aha! I got the same guy!
Oh yeah!
Oh,
trade! Got me with the main gun too. This is gonna be a little bit tricky. I'm gonna super jump right here, hoping to not get utterly killed by what I think might be you.
Nope.
That's a cherry H3 nozzle nose. Kind of funny that we're seeing two nozzle noses that are pretty good in the same match.
Okay,
got that
guy. Let's see. I'm just, like, raining down on people's heads as they pass by.
What is...
Whoop, got
where
him.
Where is that... Oh. Got you. MGL. I misread it as MLG.
MLG.
MGL is a great name to have to be misread.
I know someone's there. Oh, it was this guy. Okay. Got this guy.
See their charger.
Oh, thank you for that.
Thank you for...
Bubbler. Oh, I was chasing you!
I was about to kill him!
Dude, I was literally right behind you.
I had my Kraken and everything. I was gonna, like, activate it at the very last second and just smack him in the face.
I was chasing you with the Kraken!
Ah. 11 kills. I recall a certain... You are very aggressive. I recall a time on stream when you're like, oh, I don't feel like I did that much that game. 11 kills, 0 deaths.
Shush. We don't talk about this.
I hope I'm on your team next game. Then maybe you won't outright beat me at everything today.
Stop! Piranha pit, piranha pit, piranha pit, piranha pit, piranha pit, piranha. Yeah!
On my team, on my team, on my team,
on my team, not your team.
Yeah! We have MGL here. The Charger's not over there. I'm very happy to see that. Let's get going. I could not be happier.
You do sound very happy right now.
I do. I'm very gung ho. No, all it's left is for us to lose.
There is an Octobrush.
I see him. So he's good?
I don't know yet. They just caught me off guard. Uh-oh. We're gonna have to fight hard.
Do we have a disconnect?
I think so.
Oh, no. All right, well, we've overcome it before. You and I have. Let's see what we can do. That Octobrush is down right now.
There's two
Octobrushes. I activate my invincibility for nothing with you people. And then I get punished.
I avenged you. I tried my best.
That might be my worst Kraken usage. I always do that. I always panic whenever I have Kraken weapons, and I activate it when I don't need to. I'm kind of glad that we're on the same team, though.
Oh, I was trying to activate Kraken, but I was, like, half a second too late.
At least we both sucked in different ways, so we canceled each other out, right? Oh, boy.
I think the guy that was disconnecting...
He's back in the game. Okay, we're pretty tied up right now. We had bigger squids there for a second. We lost it though, but they aren't bigger than us yet. Never mind. Okay, Octobrush down, Splatter Shot down.
Running out of ink.
Trying to keep the pressure on with my burst bombs.
I know there's someone here. Oh, that's a vanilla splatter shot.
Yeah, I saw that too. It was really weird.
You don't see that too often. It's usually
got
the...
Got you! Double kill! I can't get the triple, so let's just get the hell out of Dodge! I've been saying that a lot today. It's really fun. It's one of the few great American pastimes that I can really get behind.
Is that a great American pastime?
I mean, I only ever hear it like on King of the Hill and stuff.
But
oh boy! Ah, no. Knew you were behind me. I was
gonna try to get you. I didn't actually think I was gonna get that kill.
I don't know. I think we might have this. They got a danger tag. They only got 35 seconds left to turn this around. If we can keep it up, I think we got this. Despite the fact that one of our teammates was sitting things out there for a while.
Oh shoot! Ink mine.
Well, I didn't say that we'd all be.
Inkmine got two of us, so don't relax yet.
That. Got a double kill there. This is a fun weapon. I know that it's not like the greatest like in ranked though, but here in Turf Wars, it's really a lot of fun. Just all that.
Do the thing, paint faster.
Double crack. I had to crack in to avoid that. Ooh.
I can't tell.
Come on.
I think it's us?
Yes!
Ooh, narrow victory.
And to think, if that guy was AFK for just one more second.
Yeah, right?
4 kills, 3 deaths, first place in turf coverage. It was a pretty happening game. A lot of kills on both sides. Missed 13 kills pants. All right, well, that was fun.
That was a lot of fun.
Yeah, okay. Well, with all that done, I guess I'm going to go talk to Judd now, and I guess we're also going to say goodbye to you shortly thereafter.
Aww.
But don't worry, you'll be back in the, very near future, because one of the other weapons I wanted to have you on for is actually coming up very soon in the unlocking order.
Yep.
So we'll be doing that.
You're Judd. Not rid of me just yet.
Joy. Meow. Sticking to walls isn't the only distinctive feature of suction bombs. They also take a little longer to explode than splat bombs do. But in return, their explosions deal damage over a wider area. They're perfect for chasing foes off narrow walkways up high. And I'll be happy to have you next time because we're going to be on the same team. Okay, anyway, enough joking. I really appreciate having you here. You are a far better Nozzle Nose than I could have ever hoped to be. You got 13.
15 kills in one game. That's a lot better than the 3 deaths that I would have gotten.
you can do it. I believe in you.
I think I'm competent with a lot of weapons. Nozzle nose is not one of them.
Nozzle nose is very hard to learn. It has a very steep learning curve, and I still struggle with it too. Like, especially on certain maps, it's just not the most friendly weapon to use in the world.
It can be really clumsy and awkward on some maps, though, but if you know what you're doing, you can really make it work on others. But anyway, that is all for now. Next time on Splatoon, we are going to be returning to Octo Valley triumphantly. Captain Cuttlefish is okay, right? And we're going to be taking a look at what I consider to be my main weapon for tower control. See you guys then.
Stay fresh.